Hello students, let's continue with the further topic of our life process in living organisms part 1. Today we are going to study about the process of energy production through aerobic respiration, and also we are going to study about process of energy production through anaerobic respiration in living organisms. In my earlier video we had taken information about cellular respiration. Now let's continue how process of energy production takes place with the help of aerobic respiration. Now in our diet we intake carbohydrates also, isn't it? In my earlier video we had taken information that carbohydrates and lipids, they are called as an energy giving nutrients. Now carbohydrates are converted to pyruvic acid by a process called as an glycolysis, and from pyruvic acid it gets converted to acetyl coenzyme. This acetyl coenzyme will produce carbon dioxide, water and energy with the help of Krebs cycle. Now Krebs cycle is also known as a tricarboxylic acid cycle. So in this way carbohydrates are converted to energy. Now if in our diet carbohydrates are not present, then in that case our body utilizes lipids for production of energy. Lipids means fats. These fats are converted to fatty acids, and these fatty acids get converted to acetyl coenzyme, and from this acetyl coenzyme again we can get carbon dioxide, water and energy with the help of Krebs cycle. Now if suppose lipids or fats are also not present in our diet, then in that case body utilizes proteins. Now we had also taken information that proteins are known as body building nutrients. Now proteins get converted into amino acid, and from amino acids they get converted into acetyl coenzyme, and again from acetyl coenzyme carbon dioxide, water and energy would be produced with the help of Krebs cycle. So in this way all this process occurs in presence of oxygen, and such type of respiration will be called as an aerobic respiration. Okay, now we will take an information about anaerobic respiration in living organisms. Now what is the meaning of anaerobic? Anaerobic means shortage of oxygen or deficiency of oxygen, we can say. In such type of respiration will be called as an anaerobic respiration. Now glucose molecule gets converted into pyruvic acid by a process called as an glycolysis, and it undergoes fermentation process with the help of various microbes. Microbes means microorganisms. And different types of products could be formed, such as vinegar, vitamins, etc. So in the production of vinegar, what will happen? Glucose is converted to pyruvic acid with the help of glycolysis, and pyruvic acid undergoes fermentation process. Now in second way, we can take an information that glucose gets converted to pyruvic acid with the help of yeast microorganism. Now for the production of bread etc. we add yeast to the batter, isn't it? That yeast brings about fermentation. So first step will be glucose gets converted to pyruvic acid, it undergoes fermentation, and there will be a formation of alcohol. Now which type of alcohol would be produced in such type of batter? Ethyl alcohol. What is the formula for ethyl alcohol? C2H5OH. So this is also one way of anaerobic respiration. Now in another example, this type of respiration is carried out in human beings. Now suppose when you are working very hard, or if you carry on with rigorous exercise, you feel tired, isn't it? Now in that case what will happen? Glucose gets converted to pyruvic acid, it undergoes fermentation process, and lactic acid is produced. With the help of lactic acid we feel tired. म्हणजे आपण आपल्याला थकवा का जाणवतो? कारण ग्लुकोजचं रूपांतर कशात होतं? लॅक्टिक ॲसिडमध्ये होतं. And this lactic acid is produced in our muscles, or it can be also produced in our RBC, that is red blood corpuscles. So erythrocytes is also known as an RBC. So here we have taken an information about two types of respiration, aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Now we are going to study about energy currency. Energy currency means ATP. Now students, what is the full form of ATP? Adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate. Now if you see the structure of adenosine, adenosine consists about adenine and ribose. Adenine means it is hexagonal in shape. Hexagonal in shape, that means it is having six corners, and pentagonal. So one hexagonal structure and one pentagonal structure is attached, and this would be called as an adenine. To that, one ribose sugar is attached, and the structure would be again pentagonal. So adenine and ribose will form adenosine. And there is a triphosphate. Now the meaning of triphosphate means three phosphate groups will be there. Now this phosphate group, which is attached to each other, they will break up. One of the phosphate bond will break up and energy will be released out. Okay, so here you can see one of the phosphate bond is broken up and energy is released. And here what will be formed now? Adenine diphosphate. So ATP would be converted to ADP, adenosine diphosphate. And this energy will be called as an energy currency. So we have taken an information about aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration and energy currency. Thank you very much.